Greetings one and all. Love Them Knives channel. LTK here. Real steel. Sidus. And since I'm a good citizen, they sent me one to put on my channel and review and tell you about. And oh man, I already had the Terra. Check this out. So I had the Terra, and then I got a Terra in beige, and I dyed it deep purple, and it was like a little off. So we sold that one away, but we kept our carbon fiber, which is like a laminate G10 carbon fiber. Okay, kind of flat, got a thumb ramp over here, a little humpity hump kind of thing. The Sidus has come out, and now we've gone all uptown, haven't we? So we have a contoured luminous shred. Check this out. Luminous shred carbon fiber. That's what this model is. And you can get the copper shred. And you can get the blacked out. Hold on. I guess they start at like $85 on the Real Steel thing. I'll give you the link to the Real Steel site because I don't see them on any other retailer site yet. And here's your Poltergeist read. Of course, they're a Poltergeist Works collaborative, as are many other knives that have been done last year and this year with Poltergeist Works. Really cool. Next, the blacked out version, which will be the least expensive, I believe. And you can go on there. When I give you the link to the site, you go on the site and you think, oh, this is just the blacked out version. You got to go over here and kick this drop down box to choose an option. So you can choose whichever you want. I've got the Moon Glow, obviously, copper shred, or that. Okay, next. Copper shred as opposed to Moon Glow. So you might like that better. Moon Glow is somewhat of a novelty. If I had to choose between them, I guess I'd probably stay with the Moon Glow that I've got. Everybody's going copper these days, and it's okay. I think this is kind of fascinating because it's not pure copper, so your hands don't smell like pennies, which I don't like, but no. And by the way, yeah, disassembled. Check that out. Of course, you up against the blade are these bronze washers. Behind them is a synthetic type washer that goes up against the liner, which is skeletonized, by the way. And of course, you got just the two main bolts that go through there, screws, whatever. And there's your backspacer that's in Moon Glow. It glows a long, long time. We'll talk about that in a bit. So this, I'm holding it up to the light. So you're seeing through the scales where it looks white like that. So it's, yeah, it's like shredded carbon fiber interspersed with the Moon Glow. Just learned to talk yesterday, by the way. Okay, so it is a more sophisticated uptown version and straightened out. Got the humpity hump, no humpity hump. Thumb ramp, no thumb ramp. Slender blade, no, not as slender. Both have small little sharpening choils on them. Obviously, if you want to go lanyard hole, you go through here, but there, you've got a little place in the back. So, and, yeah, pocket clip. I don't know how you want to roll with this. I mean, obviously, pocket clip, here you can go right and left hand, okay? But pocket clip here, negatory there, good buddy. So, we still got stuff in there. Hey, I had this out on the patio table last night for a long time, playing with the damn luminous Moon Glow, and wow, I finally gave up on the backspacer. Shit, 45 minutes in, and it was already like 8:30, 9 o'clock. Mom was calling for dinner, so 45 minutes in, still going. The scales, no. 20, 25 minutes, though, you could still, I mean, I put it on the ground, put a towel over it, let it sit. Now, these are on washers like I just showed you, but you can flick it out. I can't thumb flick this so much, but I can roll it. Middle finger, yeah, but I got to get gravity or a little inertia to help me out there. They will smooth out over time, but they're not bearings. So, and the cutaways are here on both knives are pretty nice. Might compare a little bit. This is between the two, might compare a little bit. Of course, you don't have a contoured scale here. These are flat and they're okay. They're finished. They're not a sharp edge or anything, but on this one, they are contoured and then they're chamfered quite a bit along here. So you can see that all the way around. Nicely done. Nicely done. And an interesting thing about this, you know, really a real, like, nicely done palm swell. That's really comfortable in the hand. And I think we probably need to jump into this real quick. Let's do a measure off. They're really, the blades, I believe, are exactly the same length or really close to that. Come on, baby. 3.5 inches, so 90 millimeters, correct? 8.15 overall. 3.5 inches. Come on, get that on there. Yeah, 3.5 inches. Maybe just a smidge longer, you know, because of this, the way this bolster drops there. But, and yeah, 8 3/8. So it is longer. It's longer. And it's taller. This is taller, you know, and that I believe is a significant thing to think about as well. Height of the blade. Let's get it up here and get all the way up here. Okay, so we got 1.39 inches. Let's 35 millimeters. Okay, let's go here. See? You like my sound effects? You have to pay extra for those. Okay, we're right there. Basically 1.13 and 28.9. So much more slender, less real estate in the pocket, but hello. How fat is the fatty? This feels more fat in the hand. And look at that, 0.58. Let's cruise along here. And okay, so I guess it's not really going to change. Let's see if I can get a little grip right back behind here. No, okay. So it's basically 0.58, 0.59 all along here. It doesn't, you know, it's not a big swell and then it comes back down. Thinner here, I'll bet. There you go. And that's all the way through. So 12.7. If it was a point, would we have 5/8? So 14.9. Big difference between that and 12.7. So this fills the hand more. I could tell that. And it feels more comfortable in the hand. You know? Moon glow backspacer. I saw a moon glowish thing on ZT. God, I'll put it in the bottom down here. I was at the SHOT Show and they added that moon glow Z, to the scale on a ZT knife for 2019, and a lot of people were going just terribly not impressed actually. This is, I mean, hey, if you're gonna get it, and if it's gonna be all pretty much the same price, maybe an extra 4 or 5 bucks for this, then over and above the G10 blacked out version, then okay, well, I can do that. That won't bother me, and it was fun at the pub the other night because I did. I kicked it with the flashlight. Oh well, just like this. I didn't bring this flashlight. I think I brought this little little dog here, but this one will go 1100 lumens. So there you go. Kick it on turbo for 1100 lumens and then give it a little, it's like you're painting it with a paintbrush. And they're going, oh man, that is cool. You know, of course, none of them know a Kershaw from a bag knife. And that's what I love about them. Except, actually, some of them do watch my channel, but they're not necessarily big, you know, knife enthusiasts. So, I mean, even in these studio lights, just really, really intense. You can see, and man, when you get, yeah, turn off the lights, buddy. What happened? And that stays, the scale's not so much, but 20 minutes is not too bad. This 45 minutes and still was visible, but I just laid the sucker on the patio, on the ground, and threw a towel over it. So it wouldn't have any ambient light or anything coming at it to keep it going and just to kind of see how long it was going to go. And it went for a while. It's kind of cool. Kind of cool. See, you can see right now. Now you wouldn't even know, would you? Maybe just a faint bit you can, nah. But you turn off the lights. Hey, just saying. Doesn't matter if it glows if the lights are on, you know. So it's interesting from that perspective. Here's my, yeah, it's not a drop shut action type thing because it's washers and it's going to take a while. And I didn't necessarily loosen this up a bunch. Didn't really want to and don't really think it would help that much if I did. I think it's just time. And wear in, and I did take it apart like I showed you, and I put a little light lube on it when I reassembled it, and I'm not sure that that helps when you have these bronze washers, or if really just the dry bronze washer against the blade would actually wear it better and produce a smoother effect. I know the OKC Rat 1, Rat 2 knives just pop right open, and they're on washers too, so this in time, but it's very usable this way. Jimping is effective up here on top, and you can see where the stop pin is. And yes, you know what? I kind of do like this separate pocket clip. So it's a deep carry, and you can see the little milling along here, which is really funny because if you look at the brand new real steel G5 Metamorph in G10 that Indiana Knives has as an exclusive, you can tell from the previous G5 Metamorph knives, they didn't have this little kind of like depression on both sides, you know, accent. On the previous ones, and all of a sudden here it comes. So they've changed your pocket clips, obviously, for more than just that Metamorph. Maybe on all upcoming knives that have a pocket clip like this, and they're deep carry, which is really cool. The lockup is solid. That's 45-50% if it's a dime's worth. And how much does it weigh? Yeah, it's not important. And we don't need to do this. Just kidding. Okay, 4.13 ounces. 117 grams. That's not bad. I mean, you're teetering on going under 4 ounces. That would be pretty doggone light, actually. Oh, well, hey. Then let's do this again if we're going to do that. If the comparison with the Terra is that important. Obviously, the Terra's heavier, 132 grams. 4.66, but 4.66, not that bad either. And they're full, you know, 3.5 inch blade, a little over 8 inches overall here, 8 3/8 here. And if you put the paramilitary 2 on here, she'll be 3.8. So it's pretty, pretty doggone close. And ergos are great on my PM too, but they're pretty good on this too. Yeah, I like this one. I like it better than the Terra. I guess I have to say that because I do. I like it better than the Terra. Terra's a taller handle, though. It's really a lot taller. Let's just do that, and I'll let you go. I guess if you want, yeah, 119. Of course, you know, this swells out, so. Yeah, 117. Thicker. Taller. You know, and let's do it the way probably we should have to start with is check it out with 1.55 as opposed to where are we here? 1.22 in this area. Is it really going to be that much different here? No, it's 111. And so it is a little bit taller here, 1.22. So, yeah, this is taller. This is not. This is fatter. This is not as fat. This is heavier. This is lighter. This is contoured. This is flat. This is chamfered. This isn't. They both have backspacers. They both have deep carry pocket clips. If you want to go left hand, well, this is probably not your baby in that regard. And yeah, I'll stick that little, I got a 4 minute thing of me on the patio, lighting it up. If you want to see that, I'll just attach it to the end. Otherwise, you can click out and go your merry way. Hey, you know what we do around here? We love them knives. If you guys haven't subscribed to this channel, you should, because we have some great table sales. I'm warning you. I know we got a really good one coming up real, real soon. Thank you so much, and you guys, stay sharp. So I got my Olight flashlight on here, and I'm lighting this thing up. I'm gonna see how long this holds it. Actually, I tried it last night on the patio, and it's amazing how this kind of just reacts. But the backspacer lasted longer than the scales. But I quit. I mean, I actually started filming it and quit at 35 minutes, but the backspacer was still going. So it's not just a novelty, but I understand how you might feel. Yeah, it's kind of a novelty. I get that. It's fun. But the thing is, it's not costing you any extra, correct? So you're just doing whatever you're doing. Here you go. See? Here you go. And there's the scales. And there's the backspacer. And we still got light coming out the back of the house. I mean, this is obviously not pitch dark. But here we go. And turn off my flashlight. So let's walk out into something that's a little darker. Yeah, I mean, we can go for a while. I don't know how long this is going to stay lit. If you were in just a normal lit room, this would, like, not even look lit after about 2 or 3 minutes. But in the dark, it still luminesces. And this backspacer, definitely. And they call this moon glow, so yeah, I would say really you can depend on that backspacer going for a pretty long time. The rest of this, not so much. Maybe 20-25 minutes,
and it's still somewhat detectable. See the difference between, the glow from here and the glow from here. This is just very intense, and it'll stay intense for a long time. But this, not so much. You can already see that it's somewhat faded. Yeah, maybe it's a novelty, but then again, are you paying a lot of extra money for that? No. So it is what it is. You get it if you want to get the shred, the luminous shred. In any case, the backspacer, wow.